vida siempre. Tú seas el número uno, Señor.
When we're at work, when we're not around people who know us as Christians, does our testimony speak of that Father, of that God who reigns in our life? Are we living to the standards that God has set for us, or are we not? He says, live in fear, and this fear is not, oh Lord, what are you going to do to me? This fear is in reverence, remembering to give Him the respect that He so deserves in our actions, in our speech, in anything that we do, that we would do it as unto God. Are we living like this? In everything that we do, do we live like this? And one thing that we like to say is, our worship is not just a thing that we do when we gather in this place. It's a lifestyle of surrender. That's worship. A lifestyle of surrendering the things that you're so passionate about, surrendering that to God. Because, like Harrison said earlier today, there's something that he loves about himself, but at the same time, he hates it. But he balances it out. But surrendering those things to God, we're able to balance it out. We're able to see the good. We're able to see the bad. But in between, that's where we are, trying to give God the glory. Trying to make sure that we're doing things right. Trying to make sure that whatever we do, we're going to glorify our God. Every word that comes out of our mouth, to our mother, to our father, to our sisters, to our brothers, whatever it is. To our landlords, whatever. Because we're temporarily in this place. But while we're here, we're representing the Most High God. And that's so special. We're representing the Most High God. Is there anything that you need? Is there anything that you want? Because although we're here temporarily, everything in this place belongs to Him. He created it. And if you invoke Him as Father, if you don't have a father, He can be your father, He can be your mother, He can be your sister, He can be your brother, it doesn't matter.
Thank you, Lord.
Because we're here temporarily. He can be all this to us, as long as we're living the right way. Because only if we're living the right way, we can call Him our Father and He's going to respond. We can scream our lungs out and say, Father, Father, Father. But if we're not living right, it's of no use. So live while you're here. Live in fear. Live in reverence to God. You're invoking His name. You better live according to how He wants you to live. There's a reason to why God placed you in the family that He placed you. There's a reason to why God placed you in the job that He placed you. There's a reason even why God put you in the prison that He placed you. There's a reason for it all. And we have to find out what that reason is and give God the glory for it. And as long as we give it to Him, He's going to order our next step. And once we get to that next step, if we're doing His will, the next step is already ordered. The Word says that the steps of a righteous man are ordered by God. So while we're here, we live in reverence to our God. It entails a whole lot of things. But you guys can get that. It says, you know that you were ransomed from the futile ways inherited from your fathers, not with perishable things such as silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, like that of a lamb without blemish or spot. A lamb would ransom, would redeem, would blot out the sin of a nation. The Lamb of God ransoms everyone in existence. Everyone who has died, everyone who is to come, the Lamb of God has cleansed us from our inheritance, from our fathers, from this world of sin, because we don't belong to this place. So His blood has ransomed us, has made us clean. Behold, from here on you are a new creature. The old things have passed away. We have to live life. We have to live life. And what is life but Christ?